Hello everyone.
So last class we have seen, I have discussed copper metallurgy, then I have discussed zinc metallurgy, then I have discussed iron metallurgy. So that all metallurgy we have seen, and in that metallurgy we have seen that we were using the temperature. We were using the temperature, that is, we were using heat. So the metallurgy which involves the heating, that type of a metallurgy we call as a pyrometallurgy. Clear? See, you see the iron, there was a use of heat, it was in combustion zone, large amount of heat was liberating. Then we have seen copper, so copper also was heated in the Bessemerization converter, and there also we were used to take the heat. And then zinc also we have seen, maximum temperature last class was 1763 something Kelvin temperature. So whether the metallurgy was of copper, whether the metallurgy was of zinc, whether the metallurgy was of iron. So this all the three of the metallurgy we have done by using the temperature. So that type of a metallurgy, it is called as pyrometallurgy. So write down definition. See, you can read from the textbook exact definition. Here just for understanding definition, you write down pyrometallurgy. So what is my pyrometallurgy? The metallurgy involves usage of heat to extract the metal from its oxide is called pyrometallurgy. Are you understanding or not? So this is the pyrometallurgy, means that metallurgy which involves or which takes the usage of heat to extract the metal from the oxide, that type of a metallurgy is called as a pyrometallurgy. Or the exact book definition, you can write down the study of metallurgy with changes of temperature, means temperature will get changed from low to high. So that's what I'm telling, no? Heat. If temperature is increasing, means heat. So the study of metallurgy with the change of temperature is called pyrometallurgy. It's called pyrometallurgy. Okay. So now we are going to discuss about the electrochemical process to extract the metal from its ore. So now we will use the electrochemical principle to extract the metal from the ore. So I write down here, electrochemical process involve in metallurgy. Clear? See, till now the extraction of iron, extraction of copper, extraction of zinc, we have just used the temperature, we have used the heat to extract the metal. So that type of a metallurgy we call as a pyrometallurgy. Now we are going to discuss, or we are going to extract the metal from the oxide by using the electrochemical principle. That is electrochemistry principle, and electrochemistry chapter is good of you and you have studied very well. So I will not discuss much about it. So I directly start the topic now. So electrochemical process involving the metallurgy, the first step in electrochemical process, we are going to discuss about delta G. And last class also I have told you about delta G. So delta G is nothing but Gibbs free energy. Delta G is Gibbs free energy. If you put here 0, so it is a standard Gibbs free energy. And you know, standard Gibbs free energy means which will work at a 1 molar concentration, 298 Kelvin temperature. Yes or no? So we are going to see this, okay? And you know, delta G 0 is equal to minus NFE not cell. This equation we are going to use, and we are going to determine, and we are going to extract the metal from its oxide. That principle remains same. So delta G less than 0 means the reaction should be spontaneous. So we have to make sure spontaneous means reaction will occur of its own. So spontaneous reaction will take place. So for the reduction of reaction, the reaction should be spontaneous. Yes or no? So to extract the metal, to extract the metal from its oxide, make sure delta G should be always less than zero. You have to make sure that delta G should be always less than zero. If you want to extract the metal from any of its oxide, so you know during the extraction, redox reaction takes place. So there will be one oxidation reaction and there will be one reduction reaction. So you have to be very well versed that sum of oxidation reaction and sum of reduction reaction, their delta G should be negative. Now to keep the delta G negative, here we have three things. One is N, the another one is F, and here E naught cell. See beta, this N is constant. Yes or no? N is constant, that is number of electron. Yes or no? F is also constant, 96500 coulomb. So variable is E naught cell. So N, F are constant. So the delta G less than zero depends on E naught cell. So to make delta G negative, always E naught cell should be positive. So to keep delta G less than zero, see, delta G is equal to minus NF E naught cell. Yes or no? Suppose if E naught cell becomes negative, so this negative and negative will become positive and delta G also will be greater than zero. So suppose what will happen, see here. So delta G is less than zero, that depends on now what? E naught cell. Now what will happen, suppose if, so E naught cell becomes negative. If E naught cell becomes negative, so delta G zero is equal to minus, N is constant, F is constant, E naught cell is negative. So finally delta G will become positive. So reaction will be non-spontaneous and reaction will not occur spontaneous. So reduction will not take place. So non-spontaneous. Non-spontaneous means reduction will not take place. Yes, or reaction will not take place. Point number one, this. Now, if E naught cell is positive, if E naught cell is positive, what will happen? See beta, delta G will be equal to minus, N is constant, F is constant, E naught cell is cell potential. Yes or no? This cell potential should be, if it is now cell potential is positive, so here positive. So negative, positive, negative. So reaction will be spontaneous. And reaction in spontaneous, so reaction means reduction will occur. Yes or no? So, to occur the reduction, or to in short, so one small note I can write down here. To extract metal, E naught cell should be remains always positive. If E naught cell remains always positive, delta G will remains negative. And delta G remains negative means reaction will be spontaneous and reaction will occur, reduction of metal from its oxide will occur. So you have to make sure that whichever metal is to be extracted from its oxide, think that their E naught cell, and E naught cell means what beta? ERHS. E naught cell is equal to ERHS, that is E cathode minus E anode. So this should always remain positive. You should always arrange the value such a way that it should always remain positive. So E naught cell remains should be always positive. If E naught cell remains positive, delta G will remains negative, and delta G remains negative, so reaction will be spontaneous and reaction will occur. Clear this part? So this everything they have given in the textbook, I have told everything. We will see one example. Clear this part? So you keep it in your mind, for the reduction reaction to occur or to extract the metal, delta G should always remain negative, so the reaction will be spontaneous. And to remain delta G always negative, E naught cell should always remain positive, and E naught cell should always remain positive, so that is E cathode minus E anode, this net answer, this difference should be always positive. If difference is negative, so E naught cell will be negative, E naught cell becomes negative, delta G will become positive, delta G becomes positive, reduction reaction will not occur, metal cannot be extracted. So to extract the metal,
this E naught cell, that is E cathode minus E anode, should always remains negative.
Negative, delta G also remains, E naught cell should always remains positive, delta G will remains negative, delta G remains negative means reaction will occur. This part is clear. Take a screenshot, then I will show one example, then we go. Clear? Sure. Now see here. Done this? So always make sure that delta G should remains negative and E naught cell always should remains positive, then only delta G will remains negative. See here, for example, this is the reaction Zn will give Zn plus 2 electron, and I will for this add on Cu plus 2 electron gives Cu. Number of times I have done this reaction, so here n is equal to 2. Clear this part? For this E naught cell is very simple, 0.76, that is minus 0.76 volt. And this is E naught cell, this is E Zn plus 2 Zn, yes or no? And E Cu plus 2 Cu. This every value what I am taking from the electrochemistry chapter, I am taking this. That is 0.34 volt. Yes sir. So 2 electron gets cut. Zn plus Cu plus 2 gives Zn plus 2 plus Cu solid. Now beta, you tell me which is the actually metal getting deposit. So this copper is getting deposit. Yes or no? So copper reduction is happening. So copper metal I will get. Now I will see whether this reaction will occur or not. We will check it out whether this reaction will occur or not. See, E naught cell means what beta? E naught cell is equal to E cathode minus E anode. See, E cathode is reduction, so that is 0.34. This is system minus, and E anode is minus 0.76. So 0.34, number of times this reaction you have done, just to show you. So 6 plus 4, 10. 7 plus 3, 10 plus 1, 11, and 1.10 volt. Yes or no? Now see beta, E naught cell is always should remains positive. Now you see delta G reaction. Now delta G is minus NF E naught cell. Whatever may be the answer. Here E naught cell is positive. When E naught cell is negative, the final answer of delta G will be negative. When final answer of a delta G is negative, means this reaction is spontaneous. This reaction is spontaneous. And this reaction is spontaneous means this reaction will occur and copper will get deposit. This reaction will occur and copper will get deposit. Yes or no? Understood? Delta G barabar minus NF E naught cell. So minus, this is minus. E naught cell is always positive. Yes or no? So minus here. Here E naught cell is positive. So answer minus. Answer becomes negative. Whatever will be the answer? Just only for understanding I am showing you. So answer remains here negative, and answer remains negative means delta G is negative. Reaction is spontaneous means this reaction will occur and copper will get reduced, so your copper metal you will get. Now understand this same reaction if I do the reverse way. What I will do? Instead of zinc acting as a anode, I'll make as cathode. So Zn plus 2 electron will give me zinc. Yes or no? So here instead of what I will do, just I will do the reverse way. Yes or no? Minus 0.76 volt, I will do 0.76 volt. Yes or no? Now it is acting as an anode. So I will act as a cathode down here. Yes or no? So the value will get reverse. Yes or no? Here I will do Cu gives Cu plus 2 electron. Yes or no? So here cathode value, this value remains same, no? Minus 0.76, Reduction potential value remains same. So this is now acting as a, in first case it was acting as an anode. Now in second case it is here it is acting as a cathode. This is acting as a cathode, now I will make as anode. So here E0, reduction potential value of copper is how much beta? 0.34 volt. Yes or no? So see here, reaction, whether we will see whether zinc will get deposit or not. Zn plus 2 Cu gives Zn plus Cu plus 2. So see here, we have to check it out. Here copper was depositing, and we have checked that reaction, the delta G for this reaction becomes negative. So reaction is spontaneous, means reaction will occur, means copper metal we can obtain, reduce. Copper metal can be reduced. Yes, this reaction will occur and we can get the copper. Now we are checking whether zinc we can get by just reversing the order. So we will check it out. See here. So E naught cell equal to E cathode minus E anode. Yes or no? Now who is cathode? The one who reduction occurs, that is cathode. That is minus 0.76. Yes or no? E cathode. No? Cathode means what? Beta reduction. So when now whose reduction is occurring? Zinc reduction is occurring. So what is the value for cathode here? Minus 0.76 volt. This is system minus. And who is acting as an anode now here? So 0.34 volt. So you get here minus 1.10 volt. Now see for this, delta G is equal to minus N F E naught cell, yes or no? This is minus, N is constant, F is constant, whatever, but E naught cell is answer is coming minus also, minus minus beta positive. So in this case delta G is positive. Delta G is positive means non-spontaneous, means this reaction will not occur, and this reaction will not occur means zinc cannot be obtained by this method. So I cannot obtain zinc by using this method by combining with copper as a anode, but I can obtain copper. I can obtain copper by combining with zinc as anode. So here why? Because for this reaction delta G is coming negative. So this reaction becomes spontaneous, means this reaction will occur. So copper is deposited. Yes or no? E naught cell, for this E naught cell become negative, so delta G is become positive. So delta G positive means non-spontaneous. So this reaction is non-spontaneous, means this reaction will not occur and zinc will not get deposited. Zinc will not get deposited. Are you understanding or not? So in this way we have to decide. So in short, metal which is to be extracted should be less negative, so that one who is less negative, it will act as a less negative means one who is less more negative anode, less negative cathode. Cathode means reduction. So see, last class you remember, more negative, one who is less negative anode, and anode oxidation occur. Yes or no? So the metal which is to be extracted, it should always act, or it should always undergo reduction, means it should always act as a cathode, that cathode reduction occurs. Yes or no? So one who is less anode, one who is more cathode. So the metal which is to be extracted, its reduction potential value should be more as compared to other metal. This everything I have told in the electrochemistry, so need not just for your quick revision. So understood this? So when I have done the reverse way, I got E naught cell positive. So see, beta E naught cell positive, so automatic delta G I got negative. And make sure that for the electrochemistry principle involved in the metallurgy, so that principle tells us only a single point, that for any particular reaction to occur, to metal to get reduced, so for that whole reaction delta G should remains negative. See here, for whole reaction delta G final answer will becomes negative, and for this whole reaction delta G final becomes positive. So where the delta G becomes finally negative, that reaction only will occur, that reaction will spontaneous and metal will get deposit, metal will get reduced. Where the answer will become positive for delta G, so that particular reaction will not occur, and here zinc matter will not get reduced. So in short point, short sentence, I want to tell like that only, that electrochemistry principle involved metallurgy just tell one point, that for a particular reaction or particular metal to get reduced or to extract a particular metal from its oxide, the redox reaction whatever it is occurring, for that delta G should be always less than 0, less than 0, less than 0. If delta G will be less than 0, so for keeping delta G less than 0, their E naught cell should be always positive. So if this condition is satisfied, metal will get reduced and metal can be extracted. If not, delta G becomes positive, so E naught cell will become negative, then metal will not be reduced because reaction becomes non-spontaneous. Clear this part? See ya. Second point I will tell, I hope you have copied this everything I have done in the electrochemistry. Clear? So one more example we will see here. Cu plus 2 plus Fe gives Cu plus Fe plus 2. Yes or no? Now you tell me, which is the metal reduced here, beta? Simple logic, plus 2, 0. This is the metal reduced and this is the metal oxidized. This is the reduce, yes or no? Reduction. So this metal will, means copper solid I will obtain. And for this, delta G is negative. It has been calculated, just for understanding I'm telling. So for this whole reaction, delta G is negative. So therefore, guarantee E naught cell for this reaction, E naught cell, that is E cathode minus E anode. That is, who will be a cathode now? The one who undergo reduction, cathode, and one who undergoing oxidation, anode. So cathode is Cu plus 2. So E Cu plus 2 slash Cu minus E Fe plus 2 slash Fe will remains positive, then only delta G becomes negative, then only reaction will become spontaneous, means reaction becomes spontaneous means copper deposition, means copper will be extracted from its ore. So this is ore only, maybe copper oxide, copper sulfate. So the copper will be extracted from its ore. You can add up. So that's what here, extracted metal is copper. So that is a shortcut, that for reaction to occur or for the metal to get reduced, For whole redox reaction, delta G should remains negative, and for delta G to remain negative, E naught cell should always remains positive. Clear this part? Remember this.
Written. So based on this, we are going to see a metallurgy of aluminium. So aluminium metallurgy is an example based on the electrochemistry principle involved metallurgy. The metallurgy of iron, copper, and zinc is an example of pyrometallurgy. So metallurgy of aluminium is an example of metallurgy involving electrochemistry principle. So make a heading, metallurgy of aluminium. It's very easy. And during the leaching process, I told you to obtain the alumina, that alumina ore we are going to use today. So write down here, metallurgy of aluminium. This is very important. And I will give you the notes also, not to worry, and we will go bit detail. In your textbook they have given very, in lesser proportion they have given, but we will go bit detail.
Written. Clear? So, metallurgy of aluminium here, ore we are using, that is Al2O3 alumina ore we are using here. Clear? So here we are using alumina ore, and alumina ore, how I obtained? So alumina ore is obtained from, where? From leaching process. If not, you can go to the my video of leaching, the leaching of silver, gold and alumina bauxite. From bauxite I obtained this. So I have told there, so you can go from that video and you can check it out. Clear this part? Chalo, next. So here ore we are using, second point. Now what we are doing? See, this alumina, what it is absorbed, what are the problem acquired during the metallurgy of alumina? So alumina melting point, Al2O3 melting point is very high. Melting point is very high. So due to this was one most important problem, that alumina melting point was very high, nearly it was 2381 Kelvin temperature. So this cannot be achieved by simple electrolytic process. So I cannot achieve. So if somehow I try to achieve this much temperature, I try to maintain this much temperature, but at this much temperature, the apparatus what we are going to use, steel tank, here we are going to use the steel tank, that steel tank itself will start to melt. Because you see the temperature is very high. So alumina is highly stable because of its oxide form. This oxygen is highly strong affinity towards this aluminium. So the oxygen is having a strong affinity towards this oxygen. Due to this reason, its melting point is very, very, very high. The melting point is so high that if I try to melt it, which is not possible actually, but suppose somehow by some means, if I try to maintain that temperature, so that temperature is the temperature related to melting point of iron and steel. So this metallurgy of aluminium I am going to do in an iron and steel vessel. So that vessel will start to melt. Alumina will not melt, but instead of alumina, in which vessel I have put, that vessel starts to melt. So what, how I will overcome this problem? So I will overcome this problem by adding two substances. So this problem is overcome by adding cryolite. Please see here, beta, cryolite, that is formula is Na3AlF6 and fluorspar CaF2. So when I will add Na3LF6 and fluorspar CaF2, so this both substance will bring down the melting point of alumina. How much? Nearly 1250 Kelvin. So on adding Na3LF6 and fluorspar, the melting point of alumina is lowered nearly 1256 Kelvin, which is easily can be achievable. And one thing more, and they will also increase the conductivity. So see, here we are getting one free of two. Yes or no? एक वस्तु एड करवा બે વસ્તુ એડ કરવાથી આપણને બધી એક વસ્તુ એક્સ્ટ્રા મળે છે ઇટ વિલ ઓલસો ઇન્ક્રીઝ ધ કન્ડક્ટિવિટી વોટ વિલ હેપન બેટા સી ધીસ એલ્યુમિના ઇઝ નોટ સો કન્ડક્ટિંગ મટીરિયલ સો નો હિયર આઈ એમ યુઝિંગ ઇલેક્ટ્રોકેમિસ્ટ્રી પ્રિન્સિપલ સો ઇલેક્ટ્રોકેમિકલ પ્રિન્સિપલ સેઝ વોટ બાય ઇલેક્ટ્રોકેમિકલ પ્રિન્સિપલ લાગે કે ના કે પેલા સબસ્ટન્સ ખુદ કેવો હોવો જોઈએ ઇલેક્ટ્રિકલ કન્ડક્ટિવિટી જેટલું સબસ્ટન્સ જેના અંદરમાં ભરેલું છે જાજુ ઇલેક્ટ્રિકલ કન્ડક્ટિવિટી સારું હશે એટલું ઇલેક્ટ્રોલિસિસ સ્પીડમાં થશે જેટલી સબસ્ટન્સની ઇલેક્ટ્રિકલ કન્ડક્ટિવિટી ઓછી હશે એટલું ઇલેક્ટ્રોકેમિસ્ટ્રી પ્રિન્સિપલ્સ જે છે છૂટું તો પડશે એટલું ઇઝીલી છૂટું પડશે એટલું ઇઝીલી ઇલેક્ટ્રોલાઇસિસ થશે નહીં હવે એલ્યુમિનાનો એક તો મેલ્ટિંગ પોઈન્ટ ઊંચો છે એની ઇલેક્ટ્રિકલ કન્ડક્ટિવિટી પણ નીચી છે બે પ્રોબ્લેમ છે લખું નથી બુકમાં પણ હું કહી દઉં છું સો એલ્યુમિના હેઝ ટુ પ્રોબ્લેમ ફર્સ્ટ પ્રોબ્લેમ ઇઝ ઇટ્સ મેલ્ટિંગ પોઈન્ટ ઇઝ ઓલ્સો લો એન્ડ ઇટ હેઝ ઓલ્સો લો કન્ડક્ટિવિટી બે વસ્તુ છે લો કન્ડક્ટિવિટી ઇટ્સ નોટ નોન કન્ડક્ટિંગ લો કન્ડક્ટિવિટી છે So to overcome this problem, scientists have decided they added two chemicals. One chemical is fluorspar and another chemical is a cryolite, Na3LF6. So by adding this formula should remember, by adding fluorspar and cryolite, what will happen? You will obtain two good reasons. First, adding cryolite and fluorspar, melting point will be lowered. First, melting point is very high. Just by adding the cryolite and fluorspar, its melting point can be easily lowered. It can be lowered down. Means at a low temperature, it will get fused. Point number two. On adding of cryolite and fluorspar, its conductivity also increases. If its conductivity will increase, electrolysis will occur very small, very speed. Yes or no? Electrolysis will occur very speedy. Clear this part? So these two are the problem. Now what we are doing? We are taking the mixture of alumina, yes or no, which we obtained from the leaching process, yes or no, Bayes process, yes or no. So we are taking the mixture of alumina, cryolite and fluorspar is taken in a steel tank lined with graphite એટલે કાર્બન જ ને ભાઈ લાઇન વિથ ગ્રેફાઇટ વિચ વિલ એક્ટ એઝ કેથોડ ધીસ ઇઝ વેરી ઇમ્પોર્ટન્ટ ક્લિયર ધીસ પાર્ટ સો વોટ આઈ એમ ટેકિંગ ધ મિક્સચર ઓફ એલ્યુમિના Na3LF6 એન્ડ ફ્લોરસ્પાર મોલ્ટન એલ્યુમિના Na3LF6 એન્ડ ફ્લોરસ્પાર ઇન અ સ્ટીલ ટેન્ક એન્ડ that steel tank, suppose this is a steel tank, and that steel tank is lined with carbon or graphite. It's aligned with the graphite. This is graphite, aligned with the graphite, aligned with the graphite. Line with graphite, which will act as a cathode. So this portion, this is a graphite. Yes or no? This is graphite. This will act as cathode. Clear this part? Write down this. The molten electrolyte, okay, maintained to enhance the conductance of the molten electrolyte iron vessel lined with the carbon, which act as a cathode. Clear this part? Now the story comes, who will come as an anode? So here with a clamp matlab ek party ho biju kahine. This clamp contains number of carbon rods. Yes or no? Or graphite rod which will act as an anode. So please write down, this is a carbon rods, huh? Rods. Carbon rods. Or graphite rods, carbon rods, something. Write down this next. After this, take a screenshot. Then write down. I'm not writing it because it will consume the time. Write down. Clear? Chalo. So a branch, write down. After this, you first pause the video, write down up to here. Then from here, I will give you one point. Write down here. The bunch of graphite roads, or I can say carbon road, which is graphite only, but in your book it is written carbon, so I'm writing carbon, are dipped into this vessel. Read of this. Into this vessel. Clear this part. So here, now I will connect the electricity, and here also I will connect to the electricity, plus and minus. See, I am supplying here electricity. So in in electrochemistry we have done two type of a cell. One is electrochemical cell, electrolytic cell. Electrochemical cell means chemical convert into electrical. मतलब chemical chemical भरे हुए electrical आपे. So chemical energy is converted into electrical. And electrolytic means electrical into chemical. So we have to supply the electrical. So बेटा this is an electrolytic cell, electrochemical cell. This is an electrolytic cell. Clear this part? Write on this. Clear? So this is carbon. This can be a copper clamp. Okay? We can write down here copper clamp. Okay? So write down. One point you write down here. Okay? So write down. The bunch of a graphite rods are deep into this vessel, which will act as anode. Now write down, which will act as anode, okay, and they are hanged, a copper na kaam latakta ho yahan, so they are hang into the mixture. The reaction occurs as follow. So see, this is molten L2O3 beta plus cryolite Na3AlF6 and plus fluor spar. So see, as this is a molten, so it is a molten in state beta. So when it is in molten in state, it will be forming Al plus 3 and O minus 2. Now what will happen? Now we will see the different reaction at anode. First we will see at cathode. Chalo. So at cathode, so this is the portion at cathode, this portion. So at cathode, who will come? Al plus 3. And at cathode, what will occur beta? Reduction will occur. How many reaction? 3 electron. At cathode, what will occur? Reduction occurs. Yes or no? So it will form Al solid. So here, aluminium will get deposit. Here, slowly, aluminium will get deposit here. So from here, aluminium is made to take out. Clear? So from here, aluminium is made to take out here. Clear? Here this is molten aluminium. So this will reaction will occur at cathode. We will see reaction at anode, beta. So at anode. Now at anode, which are the anode? This anode are of a carbon, yes or no? So these are the carbon rods, means C rod, graphite, okay. Carbon rods, no? So these are the carbon. Carbon C, yes or no? C roads. These are the carbon roads, a bunch of carbon roads, yes or no? So what will happen? At anode, this O minus 2 will go here. So here O minus 2 will go. And you know beta, at anode oxidation occur. Oxidation matlab loss of electron. Electron will be lost. How many he has gained? 2 electron he has gained. So 2 electron will be lost. So what will form? O will be formed. But you know O doesn't exist as a O. It will exist as a O2. So at anode, oxygen gas will be liberated. But this oxygen gas will combine with this carbon. This oxygen gas, because this here only this oxygen is liberating, no? Here only oxygen is liberating. So this carbon will be consumed in the reaction. So this oxygen will combine, here oxygen is liberated. But this oxygen will combine with this carbon rods. So this oxygen gas will combine with this carbon rods and forms either CO or CO2. So in short, this oxygen is combining with carbon. So slowly carbon rods are getting used up. So after certain time, this carbon rods again it is required to change. So for every 1 kg of aluminium, 0.5 kg of carbon rods are consumed. Okay. So if you take 1 kg, if suppose here 1 kg of aluminium is generated, 5.5 kg of carbon rods are consumed. So as the process is going on, frequent change of carbon rods are required. Why frequent change of carbon rods are required? Because at anode oxygen gas is liberated, and this oxygen gas is combining with this carbon and forming a carbon monoxide or carbon dioxide. So this carbon rods are continuously used up. So frequent change of carbon rods are required. And what is the calculation? On every 1 kg of aluminium generated, 0.5 kg carbon is used up. On every 1 kg of aluminium generated, 0.5 kg carbon is used up. Right on this. Clear this part? Clear? So you will obtain here aluminium solid. And aluminium obtained here in this way, it is nearly 99.9998% pure. 99.98% pure. Certain contain impurities. And further, this is improved to more proportion by Hoop's process. First, you write down this. Then I will write down here. 99 to 99.5%. I will write down here. Let it be. First, you take a screenshot. Clear? Taken screenshot. Chal. So, second point, I would like to tell here that every kg of aluminium, 0.5 kg of carbon rods are consumed. So, here, changing of carbon rods frequently is required. Frequently is required. Point number one. Clear this part? Point number two, aluminium formed is 99 to 99.5% pure. It contains certain nearly 0.5% pure is obtained. Nearly 99.99% pure copper, pure aluminium is obtained from Hoop's process. Which process? Hoop's process. Beta, here whatever the aluminium is generated, that aluminium is of nearly 99 to 99.5% pure. Further, more purity of aluminium is obtained nearly of 99.99 by Hoop's process. Clear this part? And here certain impurities. So aluminium formed here, it is 99.9.5%. So 0.5% impurities are there, and impurities will be of iron and silica. Okay, further 99% nearly 100% pure aluminium is obtained by Hoop's process. Okay, which is not in the course, but you please remember that Hoop's process. Clear this part? Okay. Are you understanding or not? And this process was first done by scientist Hall Herold. So the above process is called Hall-Herold process. Hall-Herold process. So this process is also called as a Hall-Herold process, because this process was done by scientist Hall-Herold. So this process is also known as a Hall-Herold process. I guess I've done in this electrochemistry. I don't know, but remember here. So this process is also known. This process was first done by scientist Hall-Herold, Martin Hall and Charles Hall and Martin Herold, I guess. So this process was first done by Charles Herold and Martin Hall. So this process is also known as a Hall-Herold process. Clear this part? See, this is molten alumina. What is the role of beta Na3LF6N? Na3LF6 and CF2 will increase the conductivity of L2O3 and bring down the melting point of L2O3. L2O3 melting point is very, very high and it is less conducting, so it is nearly stable. That's why I have to do this Na3LF6 and CF2. And see, here I have obtained the metal. Here I have obtained the metal by using electrochemistry principle. Clear this part? Now, understood this much? Now we'll go a bit detail. See, once more I'll do the reaction. Now at your home you can try. What try you will do this? See, at first we'll see the anodic reaction. But see, at anode what I obtained? At anode, I obtained is O-2. So it will convert at anode oxygen, there will be lost of electrons. So two electrons will be lost. Oxygen doesn't exist as a monatomic, it will exist as a diatomic too. At cathode, Al, yes or no beta? So Al plus three electron will give me Al solid, yes or no? Now see, if I want to get balance this reaction, here there are three, see here net is two oxygen will come. So two to the minus four, so here four electron will come, yes or no? Yes or no, or not, we will keep if as it is. If I keep here O-2, so it will gain 2 electron, yes or no? If I keep as it is, here how many beta oxygen are there? Here 1 oxygen, but here there are 2 oxygen. So I can do here half. So I have done here half. half hour down. Chalo, good. Charge is minus 2 here, so here also minus 2. Here aluminium is 3, but here aluminium plus 3. Aluminium is 1, aluminium is 1. Charge plus 3 minus 3, 0. Here also charge is 0. Now if I want to balance this, I'll multiply by 3. I'll multiply by 2 here. So I'll get here 3O minus 2. 3 by 2 O2 plus 6 electron. Here I'll get 2Al plus 3 plus 6 electron gives 2Al. So this 6 electron will get cancelled. 3O minus 2 plus 2Al plus 3. I'll get here 3 by 2 O2 plus 2Al. Clear this part? If I multiply by 2 on both the sides, so your net charge transfer of electron is 6 here, beta. Here net charge transfer of electron is 6. This is the net reaction aluminium solid. If I multiply by 2 to remove this, so 6O minus 2, 2 to the 4Al plus 3, 3O2 plus 4 aluminium. Clear? This will be the net reaction. 6 to the minus 12, 4 is a plus 12, minus 12 plus 12, net charge is 0. This will obtain as a cathode and this will be liberated anode. But anode, we have a carbon electrode, will combine with carbon to form carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide. Now, what I am telling this, if you take E naught for this and E naught for this, so delta G, you know beta, minus NF E naught cell, yes or no? N, you know, 6 electron, Faraday, you know, 96500, and at your home, you calculate E cathode minus E anode for E naught cell. Guarantee this E naught, who is cathode beta here? Cathode is at aluminium and anode is in oxygen. So if you calculate this answer, E aluminium minus E anode, you can see from the textbook, this answer will be guaranteed positive, then only final answer will be negative. So that's why the final answer is negative, then only this reaction have occurred. If delta G will not be negative, then this reaction would have not occurred. So for this guarantee, this reaction has occurred, aluminium has been deposited, so the delta G for whole reaction will be negative. If delta G was negative, then only E naught cell was positive. Clear this part? So just for information, I told you, so this was your metallurgy of aluminium. Clear this part? Understood the reaction, anode and cathode. And at here, carbon rod will get used up. So frequently changing of carbon rod is required. For every production of 1 kg of aluminium, 0.5 kg of carbon rod is used up. This you have to understand. I have shown you the anodic reaction and cathodic reaction two times. So I hope you have understood. Clear this part? So this was your aluminium ion. Write down the product, one key point which is not important, but write down the production of alumina. The production of alumina at international level is about 100 million tons. Clear? Uses of alumina, uses of aluminium, you can know it is a light metal. It is used to product the household parts like vessels. Used to be used in making the aeroplanes. Yes or no? It is used to make the reducing agent. It is used in making certain number of alloys. It is used to make the sheets which is required to cover the roof. And it is also required making the sheets. And it is also taken the making the foils and making the small very thin sheets so that it will keep the food hot, aluminium foils. So these are the certain uses of aluminium. This diagram will not come in the exam. Reactions are important, you can study from the textbook. Diagram is not important, diagram is only for your information. And I will share one link in my description. From that link you can visualize and you can see the animated video of Hall-Herald process. Thank you.